This video contains suggestions for introducing fractions for both regions and sets. Both during the introductory days and later use, students should be encouraged to describe and sketch figures to illustrate fractions and the meaning of these new types of symbols. For example, the figure for this fraction has 5 equal parts and 3 are indicated. Or we could say, the fraction represents 3 out of 5 parts. This is also a good time to introduce some history of these new types of numbers. At one time, we had only words and numbers for 1, 2, and many. Then about 5,000 years ago, both the Egyptians and the Babylonians were using fractions to talk about parts of things. Today we're going to introduce fraction symbols, and since this bar has 5 parts, we're going to put a 5 down here. It has 3 parts that are shaded, and we'll indicate that by writing a 3 up here. The name of this fraction is 3/5, and until students get familiar with the names of fractions, we could say 3/5. You repeat this as well as repeating the name, and after a while they'll become familiar with the names and the spelling of the names of the fractions. Now the word fraction comes from a word meaning to break, and at one time fractions were called broken numbers. So broken numbers can help students to maybe connect to the idea that fractions are used to talk about passive things. Now for a practice activity, students could select bars, place them on a sheet of paper, write the fraction for the bar, in this case is 6 parts, 4 parts are shaded. You could continue this activity. Sometimes if you want them to pass in the paper, you could have them trace the bar and mark off the number of parts. Now another activity involved using the mat. This is a fraction bingo 5 bars mat. There are 15 of these mats. This is mat 3. So the students take a mat like this, draw a tic-tac-toe frame here, and write the fractions in these 9 spots now for the 9 pies or discs. The fraction here is going to be 8. 8 out of 12. 8 over 12. And we're going to have 10. 10 twelfths. So in that manner, they could write these 9 fractions, and then down below here, they could write the fractions for these 5 bars. The backs of these mats, here's the back of mat 3, have fractions for the pies from the front. For example, 8 twelfths, 10 twelfths, and so forth. And these 5 fractions below are for the bars on the front of the mat. So students can check their answers. So there's a couple of suggestions for writing down the fractions of pies or bars or other figures. Now conversely, if they're given a fraction, say 7 over 8, they should be able to explain that this represents something that has 8 equal parts, and the 7 indicates 7 of those parts. And 7 out of 8 is pretty close to the whole thing, so this fraction is close to 1. On the other hand, 1 over 6, this fraction represents something that has 6 parts, 6 equal parts, and 1 of the parts are indicated. So this fraction is close to 0. Now, students should understand these fraction symbols and be able to give descriptions like this before they get into fraction operations. Let's look at the results of the National Assessment of Educational Progress. This test was given to 13-year-old students. They were asked to estimate the answer to 12 over 13 plus 7 over 8. You will not have time to solve the problem. The responses were 1, 2, 19, 21, and I don't know. And the percents for those responses are here. So 28% of these students said the sum is approximately 19, and they got that by adding the two numerators. 27% said this was 21, which they obtained by adding the denominators. So over 50% of these students seem to have no feeling or understanding of what these fractions mean. 24% got the correct answer of 2. And of course they should think about 12 over 13 is, you've got almost the whole, 12 parts out of 13. 7 over 8 we know is close to 1. So this test result indicates some of the importance of students being able to verbalize and understand fraction symbols. Now let's take a look at fractions for sets. We'll put some chips out here. We have 5 chips, and 2/5 of the collection is red. Three-fifths is blue. Now with a region model, we divided one object into equal parts. However, with the sets model, there are several objects here. At least it appears that way to students. And so we need to get across the idea that this is one collection. This one collection now becomes our one object. Usually, we introduce the region model first. So here's an idea for connecting the two, the region model and the sets model. We could start with a region model. Looks something like a fraction bar here. And here we have 2/5 of this region is red. And now, if we were to break these apart, talk about the collection, we'd still want to say that 2/5 of the collection is red. So things like this might help to show that it really doesn't matter whether the parts of the set are connected together, as we have seen for regions, or they're spread apart. So here in step 2, we've introduced fractions for regions and for sets. In this lesson, we saw examples of fractions for regions and sets. We also saw a National Assessment of Educational Progress test result, showing that by age 13, many students do not know the meaning of fraction symbols. It's like they were dealing with words in a foreign language. There are many research results of this type, indicating that students need more time with fraction models, and they need to be encouraged day by day to describe the meaning of fractions. This is the main menu of fractionbars.com. The first line, Fraction Bars Program, has details and examples from the Fraction Bars Teacher's Guides, materials, worksheets, and workshops. The second line, Teaching with Fraction Bars, has 22 videos, one of which you are now watching. There are 8 interactive fraction games in Set 1 and 8 fraction games in Set 2. These games involve equality, inequality, and the 4 operations on fractions. We'll now look at the game Beat the Clock from Set 2 of these games. The game Beat the Clock can be played against another player, or in this case, we'll play against the clock. The player types their name. We'll choose the beginner level. The player clicks a bar and then types his fraction, then clicks a clock to stop it. In this game, the player will be given 6 bars, and the object is to type the fraction for each of the bars before the hand on the clock makes 1 complete revolution.